Whenever a pirate would hide his treasure, he would leave a map behind so others could find it. All they would have to do is go to the X on the map and dig it up. I always thought this was very strange. To make it easy, kind of made it lame. I mean, I think about it. What if somebody told you that you could walk down to the drugstore and dig a hole in the back, that you would find a mountain of gold buried behind the building? Well, I imagine you would think that'd be pretty boring, wouldn't you say? I mean, sure, the gold is nice, but what about the adventure? What about the journey? No, to me, the prize at the end isn't what matters the most. It's the path to get there. That's what I want. Or at least, I always thought that until the day that I found the greatest treasure of all. It was 2 days before my dad's birthday in the year 1996, and things were very different back then. For starters, hardly anybody had a cell phone. The internet was very new, and when you wanted to rewatch a movie, you had to rewind it first. My mom died when I was young, so growing up, it was just me and my dad. My dad loved movies, new, old, it didn't matter. He loved them all. Every Friday, he would take me and any of my friends that wanted to go to the theater. We loved it almost as much as he did. My dad made sure we went to church every Sunday. Rain, shine, no matter what game was on TV, we were at church. It was the one thing he loved more than movies. But to me, it was just to please him. My dad always put me first. If there was a game I wanted to go to, he'd give up his Saturday to make sure that I got there. I decided I wanted to do something special for him. My three friends offered to give me a hand. The one on the left, that's Pin. The one in the middle, Bob. The one on the right hand, that's Jam. Oh, you see the one in the front, getting the noogie? That's me. My name is Cornelius O'Brien Barks, but everyone just called me Cobb. Or, if they were looking for extra credit, they would call me Corn on the Cob. Yeah, I know, right? I can't remember who called me that first, but they must have been in charge of the terrible nickname Brigade.
Jeez, Cobb, do you have to buy the heaviest TV you could find?
Oh, I'm sorry, Bob. I forgot to let you know that your mom was in the box.
What?
Chill. He's not talking about your actual mom, Bob. He's talking about, like, the universal mom, right?
Yeah.
I would never say anything bad about your actual mom. She has cookies every time I see her. So, where's your sister's wagon?
Hey, I know I've told you guys before about Miss Langston's cookies. She makes the best cookies you have ever had. I mean, melt in your mouth, the most pins.
Knock it off.
Shut up. Okay, guys, help me with the box.
Ready? All right, Cobb. Why don't you tell me how many yards do you have to rake to get this bad boy?
22 yards. And with the snow last week, I got 8 driveways shoveled before it melted the next day.
You know, if you asked us, we could have helped you.
Oh, I know. But it wouldn't have, like, meant the same, you know, if I didn't, like, do it myself.
Yeah, I mean, plus it would ruin the accident to his dad. Oh, my son, Cobb, he's so big and strong. He's mowed all these yards just for me. Got me this big old TV.
Listen, Cobb, after you give this TV to your dad, can I keep the box?
I mean, yeah, if he doesn't break it.
What, you think he's not going to like it?
Oh, no. I know he'll love it. You remember what I did, like, last year when I got my bike? You remember what happened to that box?
Oh, yeah, that box was totaled.
But why do you want it anyways?
He probably wants it so he can sneak around dinner or something.
Dude, come on. Hey, Cobb, where are you going?
I'm just going to let my dad know where I'm at. Dad?
Oh, If I had to choose one, though, I mean, it'd be Raphael. He's easily the coolest one. I mean, no choice.
I mean, it's a good choice, I'll give you that, but definitely could have chosen better.
Yeah, like three better choices.
Wait, are you guys kidding me? You asked the question knowing who I was going to pick. They just, Cobb, can you believe these guys?
Okay, let's get going, guys.
Hey, did I tell you guys I got a job working at Mr. Cobb's hat store this summer? I mean, that was the easiest way to pay for my new bike. You guys wouldn't believe how much he's paying me. $4.75 an hour. Can you believe that? I'll be a millionaire in what, like 2 years? Maybe three?
A millionaire? Yeah, I don't think so, wise guy.
Oh, you're a little bit slower. No, look. So, $4.75 an hour, 24 hours in a day, okay? 7 days in a week, 52 weeks in a year. Think about that. That's a lot of money.
Yeah, why don't you use all the money to buy a calculator? Am I right, guys?
Will you guys calm down? Cobb, let's put this in the garage, and then we can go hang into my room, all right?
All right.
Hey, Miss Langston.
Oh, hey, boys. Where's Franklin?
Oh, him and Cobb are just putting the present in the, I'm sorry, are you making cookies again?
Why, yes, I am, but you boys will have to wait for tonight because these are for the church picnic. Your family's going to be there?
I mean, they should be, unless things have changed.
Yeah, I mean, my mom practically lives there, so we'll be there for sure.
Oh, well, you boys can have some cookies tonight. You can just settle with some fruit.
Hey, Mom.
Hey, Miss Langston.
Oh, hi, boys. No running in the house!
Sheesh. Yeah, if you just bring yours to church tonight, we can trade.
Wait, who told you I was going to church tonight?
Your mom, of course. She said Franklin will be there.
Wait, who is Franklin?
I am, you idiot.
Oh, yeah, I almost forgot.
How would you forget that? You ninnies were the ones who started calling me Bob in the first place.
Not exactly. Who was it again who started that nickname?
Oh, you know, that girl from Sunday's, Annie.
No.
Matilda.
No, it was an actress's name.
Oh, Macaulay Culkin.
That's
a boy's name, stupid. Her name was Kirsten.
Oh, Kirsten.
That's it. How did that story go again?
Well, you don't have to.
Want me to tell it?
No.
I will now tell it. Okay, so there we are, Sunday school, drawing on our stuff, pieces of paper, pencil falls, rolls under her chair. She picks it up, looks at him. She says, ready for this?
Go ahead.
Did you drop this?
Okay, and what did he say?
What did he say? Nothing. Didn't say a single word the whole time. Just stared at her in the eyes.
Ooh. Ooh.
Didn't say a single thing. So she goes, what's your name?
Okay, well, what'd he say then?
Nothing again. So she goes, you look like Bob. I'll call you Bob. Those two were inseparable the whole day.
Aw, so cute.
It's adorable.
Yeah, I mean, what happened to them anyway? Her anyway?
Oh, she was just visiting for the day, so her family left the next day.
I mean, what was I supposed to do? She had candy, right?
I mean, I have candy usually.
Okay.
You usually hang out with me.
A, B, C, it's simple story.
Hey, excuse me, bud. What are you doing?
Well, of course I'm practicing for my solo tonight.
Ain't nobody going to be singing whatever that was tonight.
Well, what were we singing, huh?
The same thing we sing every year. You already know. Every verse of
Amazing Grace.
While I sure would have liked to keep singing with my friends, I was curious about what was in the letter from my grandpa. At first, I was disappointed because no money fell out. But I began to read the letter. Dear Cornelius, I was hoping to visit you soon, but I'm in the mountains right now and can't make it. But don't worry, because I have a present I think you'll enjoy. In the envelope, you'll find an old map and an old note. Please be careful with these. They are very fragile. Apparently, the map belonged to an old sailor who found some very old treasure.
A lot of old things going on here.
The sailor stumbled upon a treasure so grand that he couldn't spend it all in a lifetime. No, two lifetimes. Being a humble sailor, he took a small portion and decided to leave the rest for others to find. He left the map and the note that led him to the treasure as well. The note gives us information about the pirate who hid the treasure, things like how he thought and what his intentions were. Using these two, I'm sure you could find it as well. I just hope you will take a chance and see if you can find this grand treasure just as Henry did so long ago. I love you, Cornelius, and remember, nobody ever found anything by staying put. Grandpa. I couldn't believe it. An adventure just tossed into my lap like something you would dream about. And the next thing I thought was, are my legs asleep? Because I'm still seated.
Guys, you gotta look at this.
Dude, inside voices, man.
Oh, okay, no, this is really important, guys. I got a treasure map in the mail.
What are you talking about?
I got a letter from my grandpa, and he said there's a note and a map and treasure we can find.
Listen, Cobb, you come into my house, Cobb, and you start eating my cookies.
Oh, no, actually, I tried to get cookies. Your mom slapped my hand right out from under them. You can't get no cookies.
Thanks, Pin.
No problem.
Now you come into my house, Cobb.
Oh, wait, actually, why I got you here. This isn't your house, because really, you didn't pay any
bills. I'm doing something here!
Okay, go ahead.
You come into my house, and you go off in the corner, start reading your note
treasure
and your
map.
Yeah, and you think I'd be upset about it,
but
I'm not.
Just look at it.
And then I'd find out that it's an actual treasure. Guys! Look, this is an actual treasure map!
Let me see.
Come on, you're just tanking my team, dude.
Guys, you gotta be careful with it. It's old. Grandpa said it was old. Come on.
Hey, wait. Cobb, you got a note here, too. It says something about big rock, skull, treasure.
A skull? Wait, skull means danger, right?
No. Skull usually means death.
Oh, I mean, I can live with death.
Good, because you guys will be really acquainted with it if you're not careful with my map and note. Now, let's see what the map has on it.
Oh, okay. See, there goes the skull again. Let's say you don't make it back from this, you know, just... You suppose I can get your bike so I can stop working?
I guess that's fair, like... You get mine.
Oh, wait, that means you get the piece of crap that Jam has.
Okay, dude, you can use it for spare parts, alright? Come on.
Back to the map. Okay, doesn't this kind of look like the convenience store area?
No, it looks nothing like the convenience store area.
No, you haven't looked at it enough yet. Like, give it two more seconds.
No, nothing like it at all.
No, it's definitely the convenience store.
Yeah, I guess it kind of looks like the convenience store.
Okay, he guesses it kind of looks like the convenience store. It looks nothing
guys,
like it, okay?
Guys, let's check the first clue of the map. And then after, we'll do whatever Jam says next. How about that?
Okay. All right. I often start my trip at what looks like a troll frozen by sunlight. Sometimes I think it looks like it's about to jump at me, but it's just my imagination. I leave my compass under its feet so I can continue. It is very important. The compass isn't a normal one. It helps with the coordinates on the map, so it's vital to the search. Hurry, you don't have time to waste.
Rock monster it is.
Well, okay. Let's go.
Yeah, Hold on. Guys, our parents wouldn't want us going out late into the evening hunting treasure, right? Plus, we have church later tonight.
Oh, you're right. Oh, yeah, no treasure.
No treasure,
Guys, I usually go somewhere with this. I'm just saying our parents can't know we're sneaking out.
Like spy stuff.
He gets it. Now, follow my lead.
Thank you.
Bye, Miss Langston.
Bye, Miss Langston.
Oh, bye, boys. See
Traitors.
You tonight.
And just like that, we were off. We had no idea what kind of adventure was waiting for us. We just knew we had to find it. If we didn't, we wouldn't be able to forgive ourselves for letting something like this slip through our hands. No, we were determined to see this through to the end.
Yeah, I don't know about this, guys. My mom said I'm not supposed to hang around in this area.
What? Why? What's wrong with this area?
Well, you know, just recently there's been a lot of robberies in the area. You know, it's all been by the work of Jake Jackson.
Blake Shelton? Who's that?
No, you big dope. Jake the Snake Jackson.
Oh, yeah. I remember now. I heard he stabbed the guy trying to call the cops on him.
Did he stab a guy, like, dead?
No, I think he got stabbed in the arm, but...
You know, worse than that, I heard that he went around to all the kids' birthday parties in town and went and popped their balloons because he hates happiness.
Okay, I'm not going to believe something that stupid. You had me for a minute, but honestly, like, going around popping balloons... I'm no fool.
Yeah, I mean, that's like the lamest supervillain ever. No way.
Hey, it's just what I heard.
You know, I heard he shot a guy.
Like with a gun?
Okay, guys. Don't worry. Let's think about this logically, right? We're in town looking for treasure. There's everyone out here who's not worried about Jake the Snake, right? And treasure's way more important than our lives. So, who's with me for treasure?
Okay.
Well... Besides, we have God watching over us. Right, guys?
Right!
I always thought how strange it was. These three actually talked about God, even when we weren't in church. I would catch them doing it every now and again, but for me, it was never instinctual. I mean, the way I see it, you pray at church, or before you eat, or when someone dies. After I gave that speech, it wasn't what I said that put a smile on their faces. It was what Bob said about God.
Well, if I'm reading the map right, which I'm not sure if I am, this is the right spot.
Yeah. Oh, you're right. Look, it's Mayor Julian. This is the closest thing to a troll I've ever seen, guys.
Must not have a mirror in your bedroom.
Wait, guys, wait a second. Think about it. If Mayor Julian's statue's here, then that means the rock monster statue's gone.
Oh, and if that's the case, look, the compass is gone, crushed underneath Mayor Julian's monster feet.
Wait, but no compass means no treasure.
Oh, game over, I guess.
Guys, try not to quit so easily. Let's just ask around and see if anyone else seen this compass?
Just want us to ask everybody? I mean,
just...
Guys, before you ask everyone, let's look at this real quick. Doesn't that kind of look like a compass?
Dude, would you quit your yapping? Those could mean anything.
Yeah, and who's ever heard of a compass with 5 points on it?
Okay, obviously, one that's pointing the direction we need to go, right? Never eat sour wheat that way.
That way, the convenience store? He wants to go to the convenience store. He wants to dig up a hole, clean up on aisle 1 and aisle 2 and aisle 3, and there's a giant crater in aisle 4. What are you boys doing here?
Okay, obviously, it's not talking about the convenience store. It's talking
you
about something.
Just pointed at the convenience store!
Something that direct.
Guys!
Like, there's things behind it.
Guys, check the note again. Maybe it has a clue.
Bob, you're a genius!
Yeah. What?
Well, think about it, right? The note says you use the compass under the feet on the map, right? So if we use the compass with the map, and we do that, and we orientate it like that?
What?
Is this way right?
Yeah, you see the mountains? This way.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, okay, so the mountains in the back, compass right there, compass right here.
Wait, let me see. There you go. Oh! Look at that. It's vital to the search. Hurry, you don't have time to waste.
Shut up.
Knock off, Pin.
Just saying.
Okay. So, if we line everything up, we need to go that way. That way.
And what's that way exactly?
Town center.
Okay.
Makes sense.
And what are we looking for in town center?
We'll find out when we get there.
And so we made our way to the town center. We weren't sure what we were looking for or where to find it, but we knew we were heading in the right direction. There were a lot of people shopping and more just walking around enjoying the nice weather and spending time with their families.
So, if I'm reading this right, we just need to keep going this way.
Oh, hello, boys.
Hi, hey, officer.
Hey, now I know you guys are just out here having fun. Hey, but don't stay out too late now, you hear?
Yes, sir.
Yep, no problem. Oh, yep. Hey, officer, is it true that you guys caught Jake Jackson, the snake?
Son, you know I can't give you that information. Now you guys go on your merry way and stay out of trouble, or I'll have you in the same cell as him tonight.
Oh, thank you, sir. Did you guys hear it? Hey, guys!
Oh, jeez, hey, Pete, there.
I was excited.
Hey, let me see this note again.
Here you go.
What's the note look like, Ben?
The note? Oh, yeah. No, it's, let's see, a bunch of words, stuff we already read, time to waste, yeah.
Listen.
Well. No. That's too easy.
Shop.
No, that's stupid. You said it wasn't the convenience store. So, no. We have to think outside the box. In between the lines, moving forward like a shark, never going backwards. Yeah?
I got nothing, man.
Same.
It's vital to the search. Hurry, you don't have time to waste. Hey, bud, how does this thing know we have a bedtime?
Oh.
You have a bedtime?
Pin.
You don't?
I don't think it's talking about our bedtime. I'm just thinking, maybe time has something to do with the clue.
Here we go again. Sure, and how do you know, Smarty Pants? Go ahead.
Well, the last clue had to do with the thing in the center, which is the statue. And then this clue has to do with the thing in the center as well, the clock. Clocks tell time, time to waste. Clocks tell time.
Oh, Bob, you're a genius.
There it is.
Clocks tell time. That makes sense.
Guys, look, there's some numbers on the back of the clock.
And the letter.
What? What are you two talking about? Oh, G12. What does G12 mean?
I currently do not know exactly what that means. However, given enough time, I would, but he could just do it for us.
Yeah, what do you think, Smarty Pants?
Oh, me? Well, if I have to figure it out, I'll take that note, thank you. Oh, and I'll just borrow that map from you, if you're all so kind. Now, if I was a betting man, which I'm not, I would have to say that the answer to that question that we've all been asking would have to be, without a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah?
Now, hold on, I was getting there. Without a shadow of a doubt.
Get on with it.
Fine, if you really want to be that pushy about it. We're going that way.
Okay. What? And why do we need to go that way?
Well, do you see how the map's on a grid base with the numbers going vertical and the letters going horizontal?
Great Scott, boys! He's right! Look!
Okay, smart guy. Maybe you got it right this time. Why else do we need to go that way, Einstein?
I come here. So I noticed the note, it has a crease in it.
Oh, Cobb, look, the note opens, Cobb, look!
You telling me we've been doing this the hard way the whole time?
Well, no, hold on. It looks like we're still going the right way, right, Jam?
Yeah, I mean, all this says is, hey, dummy, go north, which would lead us to a turtle, I think, saying, hey, stupid, go east. And it looks like my grandma saying, hey, doofus, go south, which would take us to right about here. So, yeah, I mean, we're good.
Yeah, I guess that's enough.
Yeah. On the right now. Yeah, I guess that's fine.
What, did you forget how to read or something?
We just figured, you know, you're the smartest guy around. You could just work your magic again.
I don't want to overdo it. Let Cobb figure this next part out. It's his treasure.
Okay. You just want that?
No, he's holding out. Yeah.
That's fine.
Okay. Let's see here. You found the code, but do not tarry. Head to the coordinates and there and find Sherry. Is this guy a poet now? He was writing sentences with stories and like answers. Now he's writing poetry that doesn't even rhyme that well. This is useless, guys. We're never gonna find it.
And seriously, who's Sherry? How are we?
Okay, guys, how about this? Let's go to the coordinates and then we'll complain about the note, okay?
Sure.
And without another comment or snide remark, we followed the map to the next clue. It wasn't very far from where we were, but the whole time I couldn't put my mind at ease. I kept thinking that I was missing something. But what? None of my friends seemed to have any concern, so why was I so nervous? We made our way further through town. The only thing that wasn't really a building was the old dried-up well in between some stores.
All right, I think we're here. Go ahead.
Who is Sherry?
And what are we going to do? Run around the whole town asking every single old person until we find one that knows something because they're 100 years old and when this map was made?
Well, that's all I got. Pin, check that note one more time. What does that note look, or map look like?
Oh, the map. Bob, you're a genius. Look at that. There's grid lines. Oh, a town. Ooh, treasure. Yeah.
Okay, I kind of walked into that, but can we be serious for a minute? What does it say about here?
Oh, this is the spot with the skull on it.
Oh, yeah, I gotta go, bud. A spot with a skull sounds kind of dangerous. My mom's probably worried about me.
Okay. Think for a second here, right? We snuck out, didn't we? Right?
Yeah.
So how can our parents be worried that we're gonna die if they don't know that we can die?
Yeah, I guess you're right, bud. Okay, sure.
So, hey, I guess while we're looking at the map, maybe you should go ask that guy over there if he knows anything.
Yeah, he looks about 100 years old. Excuse me, sir, do you happen to know anything about a Sherry?
Sherry who?
Bob, Cobb, Sherry who?
That's what we're trying to figure out.
No, but I mean, like, give me something to go with.
Oh. Sherry with a skull, last name skull, something skull.
Sherry with a skull, sir.
Sherry with a skull.
Is that a no?
Well, you're probably talking about Sherry Sprinkler. When the well dried up many years ago, Sherry came down to the well to get water like she normally did, and she looked down in the well to find out why the water wasn't coming up, and she fell in, and she died in the bottom.
Which explains the skull on the map!
Thank you, sir.
Sure thing, fellas.
Okay, so if we have to go in, guys, I guess since I'm the bravest out of all of us, I'll just go first.
Hang on a second. I talked to the old man. I think, you know, I should go down first.
I think rock, paper, scissors to decide.
All right.
And so, we all worked our way down the well. Everyone decided they wanted to be the first one down, so we all went at the same time. Then, after realizing that was a bad idea, we agreed that it should be done one at a time. We decided that Pin should go first, since he was the best at rock, paper, scissors. The rope for the well was very strong. It actually seemed pretty new. Luckily, it could hold our weight going down. The bottom of the well was very dark, but when you got there, you could see it open to a large area, at least large in height.
Man, I can't see a thing. Anyone got a light?
I was waiting for you to ask. I always keep this bad boy on me.
What? Why do you have a flashlight?
What? Hey, open your eyes, bud. You never know when there's going to be a...
Echo!
Shh!
I'm just admiring the acoustics in here.
You're gonna be admiring bats in your hair if you don't calm down.
Bats!
Whoa. Don't you worry, Joker. You leave them bats to me, all right? Now, which one of you wants to be my Robin? Nobody? Seriously?
Cobb, can I get your secondary opinion on this?
Yeah, what is it?
What does that look like to you?
Oh, kind of like a Oh no, man.
Oh, please, Cobb, please tell me he's not dead. I can't handle this.
I mean,
he
can't be dead, right?
I mean, Jake the Snake's on the loose. He could have thrown the body down the well. It's a good place to hide things, right? I mean,
why would you say that?
Cobb, I'm freaking out back here. You gotta do something.
Like what?
Well, whatever, you don't touch it, because if it's a dead body, it could like incriminate you or whatever.
What? Is that true?
Well, I saw it in a movie once.
We've seen the same movies. I don't know that.
Okay, it was some obscure reference. Just the point is, don't touch it, okay?
Okay, fine. We won't touch it, but what are we going to do with it? Call the police? Bury it? I mean, everybody deserves a burial, bud.
I'm still freaking out back here. Just do something.
Okay.
Anything.
Okay, I will. I'll do something. Give me that blanket. You take this. And I'll cover the body. I won't touch it. I'll just cover it. Just slowly.
Just don't touch
very
it.
Very slow. I'm not going to touch it.
Okay.
Slowly. Until he's covered. Okay, everyone happy? He's covered now? He's good? Everyone happy?
Not really.
Okay. Pretty silly. Let's look at our clues.
All right. Well, the map was only above ground, so it's going to be useless here.
Okay. So we have to look at the note.
The note say?
What are you doing down here?
Oh, no, come on.
I said, what are you boys doing down here?
Nothing, sir.
Haven't you heard? There's a criminal on the loose. You guys haven't happened to see him, have you?
Oh, no, sir.
No, sir. No criminal.
No, for sure.
Oh, no, for sure.
Pick up.
Sir, I think you dropped your chapstick. Or is this a boy?
Give me that. Now, I would hate to hear that he ran into you guys and something awful happened to you. That would just be horrible, wouldn't it? Now, why don't you guys get out of here and forget you ever saw me? Capiche?
Oh, yeah.
No problem,
hey.
Sir.
Oh, Cobb, I thought the cop said he caught the snake.
Why would you say that now?
Who said that now?
Now, listen here, but hey, nobody ever caught Jake Jackson before. Hey, get back down here.
Please, sir, you have to let us go.
I ain't got to do nothing. Now, you brats, stay right here. I've got to go run some business in town. And when I get back, I expect you to still be here and quiet, because if you yell, how about I cut your tongue out?
No, sir, please, stay here
and shut up.
Please, leave us down here, sir.
Come on.
Oh, man. Okay, guys, I took the rope with me.
Oh, now we're stuck down here without Troy's bucket to get us out.
What are we going to do?
Listen, Cobb. I didn't mean to run my mouth like that, man. I was just scared.
Bob, it's okay. I know. We're all scared. I shouldn't have called you a blabbermouth. I was just nervous.
Hey, Penn, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm just praying that maybe he at least gets me out of here and just takes you guys if he could.
You know what? Why don't we all pray and not for that?
Okay.
I decided I would pray too. I don't know if it was because I was so scared, or if it was so the others could see me praying. Either way, no one was forcing me. Lord, why am I here? I go to church every Sunday. My friends are all Christians, but things still go wrong for me. Why? I honor my Father like your word says, and I even tithe. So what are you doing for me? I worked so hard to get my dad that nice present, and now I won't even be able to give it to him because I'm stuck in this stupid cave.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Let's collect ourselves. Look at that note. Maybe we can still find this treasure.
The treasure? He's going to come back and cut our tongues out. Why do we care about a treasure?
Well, I mean, we're already stuck down here. Might as well find the treasure while we're here, right?
Yeah, I guess that's fair enough.
Okay, we could try that. Let's see, where do we leave off? Okay. Oh, here we go, yep. At the darkest of darks and my lowest of lows, I always know where to look.
Oh, look where?
Yeah, Well, no, that's actually all it says. It just, I know where to look. So I guess we could just search the cave. I mean, yeah.
Okay, we haven't done all that yet. I'll go over here.
Yeah, I see nothing over here but a bunch of rocks, boys.
I got nothing over here.
I just got a little hole over here. I mean, it's pretty pitch dark on the other side, so I don't know what it is, but...
Hey, Bob, you find anything?
Oh, you bet I did. Look at this. That idiot left his lunch down here. Classics, half a Twinkie, and what? Half a juice box.
Dude. Hey, put it down.
What? Gross. It's raspberry flavor.
I don't know where that dude's been.
He doesn't know where I've been.
You could have said nothing. I mean, that would have been just as good.
Disgusting.
All right. Lowest of lows, I always know where to look. If I was at my lowest of lows, I'd probably look up, right?
That's right. The ceiling. The one place we haven't looked. It has to be up there. Like some kind of like stalagmite, stalactite, one of the two, right? It has to be up here.
I don't see anything, Cobb.
Yeah, I see no stalagmites.
No. It has to be. Like, there's nowhere else to look.
Now, okay, hold on. You're way off in left field, Chief. Let's try this again. It says, darkest of darks.
Check.
Okay. Lowest of lows.
Check. We got that part.
I always know where to look.
It's not the ceiling, dude.
It's definitely the ceiling.
It can't be. There's nothing up there. You can see as
the
good as
the darkest of darks.
Yeah, you're right.
And the lowest of lows.
Oh, Smarty Pants is bad.
I always know where to look. Guys! I got it.
Okay.
The guy who wrote the note, he's a Christian.
And that helps us why?
Well, if you were a Christian at your darkest of darks and your lowest of lows, where would you look? Inside. Well, I hope they would.
No, he's right. Let's try the hole.
The hole? None of us can fit in the hole.
No,
it's
okay.
Too small.
You're not thinking about it right, bud. It's one of those things, you stick your hand in, you get the lever, yank the lever, the thing happens with the...
You're right. We've seen this in a movie. We stick our arms in, the thing clamps our arms, and then cuts it off. But someone brave has to do it. So, I mean,
you're right.
Who's going to be brave?
Those goes. That's the rules, bud.
Sorry, bud.
Oh. Okay.
I mean, anyway, Penn, if he, you know... You get his bike.
It's not funny, guys.
But it's so true.
It just, look, stick your hand in there and get like a lever or something. It's in there.
No, I don't feel a lever.
No?
No, but I do feel a button. It's kind of like furry, weird feeling. I'm going to try to press it, okay, guys?
Okay, yeah.
Okay. On three. One, two, three. Ah!
Oh, you big dope.
Yeah, that wasn't funny.
But so true.
All right. I'm going to give him a wedgie.
No.
We need his hand. We need his hand. Come on.
I'll do it again.
You're lucky.
Remember, a lever. You just pull the lever. It'll do something.
I know what a lever does.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you feel a lever?
You're right. I do feel a lever this time.
I knew it.
Okay. I'm going to pull it on three.
Okay. No more
One,
games.
Two, three.
Guys, the wall's moved. It's forming a door.
There's a small room back there. You have the light.
Guys, all that's in here is a boulder.
Oh, hey, why don't we try to move the boulder? You guys stand over here. Me and Jam got over here. Okay. Ready?
Now, hold on a second. Is that what I think it is?
I mean, it's the only thing it can be, right?
Guys, X marks the spot.
Okay, guys, let's open it, okay?
Books?
Cobb, there's a note.
A note? Dear Hunter, what you see in the chest before you are the copies of the Holy
Scriptures. Dear Hunter, what you see in the chest before you are copies of the Holy Scripture printed in the year 1896. We were set to bring our supplies to the mainland when our ship was boarded by a band of pirates. They took everything we had, stripping the ship clean of anything that could be of use to them, supplies, tools, even the lanterns and oars, they took it all, being left with nothing but the clothes on our backs. Me and my mates had to swim to shore on a makeshift raft we crafted from damaged parts of the ship. It was no easy task. The raft was crude with splinters sticking out all over. This raft took on a lot of water along the way. Almost all of us got frostbite, and the ones who weren't so lucky ended up passing away to the cold, including my best friend. After we arrived back on shore, the villagers helped take care of us till we were of better health. When I was able to move again, I asked around town if anyone saw the pirates that wrecked our ship. An old man said that they were selling several supplies to the shops around town. Of course, most knew they were pirates and didn't want to buy from them, but you could say they had their hands tied. He also mentioned that anything they didn't think would be of any value was tossed away. I asked the old man where, and he pointed me to the well in the corner of the town. I knew it wasn't a good idea. Most things would be ruined by the water, and I couldn't stay in there too long without dying either. I lowered myself down the rope, finding a broken piece of wood to stand on. Floating there and looking around, I found one of the chests we had on the ship, so I hurried over to open it. I couldn't believe it. Inside was mine and all my mates' personal Bibles, all safe, undamaged, and dry inside the chest. How could this be, I thought. I began to think that he put them here for a purpose. Plus, I couldn't get them out without risking them falling into the water. I also had no help getting them out of the well. And that's when it hit me. The case kept them safe from the water and being damaged. Maybe there's a reason they all ended up safe down here. So I write this note to you, finder of my lost treasure. This may be the last piece of my crew left on Earth. I hope my men and I left a good testimony for you.
Wow. Yeah, Cobb, you're gonna be okay, man?
No, yeah, I'm gonna be fine. Yeah.
Are you sure? Because I'm looking at you. You don't look like you're going to be very good.
Well, it's just, it all caught me off guard, man.
You know what, guys? Let's all take one.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
That's a good idea. Guys, there's a hole in the wall.
And there's a ladder back here, too. We're safe.
We all made our way up the ladder. It surfaced not too far from the well, just behind some trees. We each took one of the Bibles with us and sealed up the chest. We made our way to the police station and explained our situation to the officer. At first he thought it was a prank, but eventually he followed us back to the well. And after seeing the place, I think he was convinced. He told us to move along, not wanting us to get caught up in the mess. And after everything that we went through, we didn't argue with him. After Bob noticed what time it was, we all realized we were a little late for the church picnic, so we made our way straight there. When we arrived, you could see Miss Langston was not happy with Bob.
So that's when I told Jack Johnson or whatever his name was, keep your bullet, don't scare me.
We were all there, man.
Oh my gracious.
Franklin, Alan, Langston. Where have you been?
Mother, have I ever told you how lovely you look tonight?
Drop the act, Buster.
Act? Mom, me and the guys, we were just hanging out.
Where at?
What?
Like, where on God's green earth was you hanging out at?
We're in the, Come on, Ben. Help.
Oh, no problem. Miss Langston, we were in a well.
You're killing me, Smalls.
In a well? You all couldn't even pick a story to stick to before coming in here?
Excuse me. I'm here looking for the boys who go by the names of Cobb, Penn, Jam, and Bob.
They're right here, officer.
Well, thank you, ma'am.
Oh, and you can have what's left of this one after I get done with him.
Oh, ma'am. I'm just here to congratulate these boys on a job well done.
Job well done.
Absolutely. On behalf of Mayor Julian and our entire town. I want to congratulate these young boys with their assistance in the arrest of that thief, Jake Jackson.
The snake.
Now, if you boys would line up quickly right here, I'm here to present them with these pins of wings.
So, what do these mean?
I have no idea what they mean, but I can tell you this. The city thanks you, boys. No, you young men.
No. The bucket punch.
What does that mean?
That's what they've all been wondering.
Now, boys, I must continue to fight crime and get back to work.
Thank you, officer.
Officer, one second before you leave.
Anything for the kids.
Is it true what Jake Jackson did? Like he stabbed a guy?
Oh, and popped the balloons?
Or shoot a guy?
I'm here to tell you, boys, that none of that is true. You see, the snake was just a small-time crook. Never hurt anyone, didn't kill anyone either. As a matter of fact, the gun he had, it was just a prop, just to scare the employees. Lucky for him, he wouldn't rob the ones who would shoot back.
So we were wrong all along?
Well, not exactly wrong about everything.
Yeah, what do you mean?
Well, you see, he really does hate happiness. Once, he crashed a kid's birthday party, chased all the kids out, and popped all the balloons.
That's what I said.
I doubted it.
That's what I said.
Man. Now, boys, you all have a great day and stay out of trouble.
Thank you so much. Well,
officer. Thank you.
We're going that way.
I told you guys about the balloons. That's what I said. I said the balloons. He popped them.
Okay, mother, do your worst.
Well, I think we can wait until later to ground you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Besides, there will be plenty of opportunities, so, you know, we'll just let this one slide.
Oh, Dad!
Oh, hey, Cobb. Did you have a good day?
Man, I had the best day. Did you see that note I got?
When I came in the mail? What was it? I bet you it was something good, wasn't it?
It was the awesomest thing ever. It was this note, and it had, like, a letter in it, and a map, and it took me all around town. I even went down into a well with my friends.
Sounds like you had quite the adventure. I'm jealous, but I can still tell something's bothering you.
Well, so we went on this epic journey, and we're gonna find the lost city of gold or Blackbeard's lost treasure. And I was thinking, would I spend it all in a day or would I save it for college? And then we opened the chest, we looked inside, and there wasn't jewels or gold. There was just books that you could find at any store. But I feel like this is more valuable.
Don't forget about the note.
You're right. There was that. How did you know about the note?
Know about what note?
The one in the chest?
Oh, that note.
You're in on this, aren't you?
Technically wrong. I was the only one in on it.
No. But the letter said it was from Grandpa.
What, you don't think I've ever forged my dad's signature before? Come on, son. Give me some credit.
Okay, so you're saying Grandpa had nothing to do with this?
Well, I wouldn't say that. You see, when I was young, Grandpa sent me on the same treasure hunt as you. Growing up, I didn't care about church or anything about it. All I cared about was my TV shows and my movies. See, growing up in a Christian family, I knew how to talk, I knew what to say, knew how to act, and I knew when I needed to pray, all to look like a Christian. But you see, the thing about dads is, we know when you're lying. And so when my dad sent me that note from my grandpa with the treasure map, and I found that treasure chest and read the note, it all hit me like a ton of bricks. Every reason I had for not wanting to read the Bible all became clear to me. Before, when I used to read it, I used to think to myself, what can I get out of this?
So, what did you learn?
It's not all about me.
And just like that, everything my dad said just clicked. It's not about me. Four little words that meant so much. I had no interest in the Bible because I was only concerned with what I could get out of it. It tells that everyone is a sinner with no hope. But because of what he did, what Christ did for us on Calvary, that we could have hope in him. That's what we get out of it. But if that's true, I can just repent of my sins and then go on living my life how I want to, right? No. It's not about me. It's about Him. If I want to understand this book, I have to think about Him. Not me. Not Cornelius O'Brien Barks. I'm just a servant. A servant that serves Him. It's about Him.
The reoccurring theme throughout the whole book, Him.
It tells of the future, Him.
And everything I need to know about myself, Him.
Him.
Man, it's all about Him.
I had everything, everything I needed. And while I'd like to thank my dad for it, it was Him. But from the look of my dad's face, I think he knew.
What do I do now, though? I've spent my whole life just doing whatever I wanted. What do I do now?
Luckily, he doesn't see things the same way we do, but I know a way you can start. How does one breath at a time sound?
What?
One breath at a time. It's a saying I came up with. It means keep your focus on Him.
Never heard you say that before.
That's just because I made it up.
You can't just make up sayings.
Hey, Cobb, we got some snacks.
Nice save. Well, Cobb, why don't you spend some time with your friends while I get a snack?
Thanks, Dad, I will.
You're welcome, Cornelius.
Cornelius.
Well, boys, we did it. We found the treasure.
And saved the town.
And though it wasn't gold or jewels, it was way more important in the end.
Yeah, I am going to miss the adventure, though.
Yeah.
Excuse me, fellas. Pardon the interruption.
What's up, sir?
I happened to notice you found the treasure from Sir Albert Faust.
That's what his name was. You know, I was starting to think we're never going to figure that out.
Yeah, that's cool. Wait, how do you know we found the treasure?
Well, you didn't get down in that well to take a bath, did you?
Oh, so we didn't know.
Have you ever found the treasure, though?
Yeah, many years ago I found it, and the other four treasures that are around the town.
Did he just say what I think he just said?
More treasures to find.
You have to tell us where they are. You like show us a map or something.
Please, sir.
Come on.
Well, it's been a long time since I told anybody about the treasures, but yeah, I'll tell you about the treasures in the maps that I have, and I'll tell you about my train collection.
Okay.
And my coin collection.
Oh, all right.
And my wig collection.
Ooh, yeah, just soldier on.
Places, everyone. Places. Quiet on the set.
Forgot? How could you forget? You ninnies were the ones who started calling me Franklin in the first place.
Not exactly. It was that girl.
Oh. I mean, doesn't that kind of look like the convenience store area?
That looks nothing like the convenience store.
Okay,
no.
Well, you haven't given it a second. Look a little closer.
I've given it like 3 seconds and it looks nothing like it.
You need 4 seconds maybe then. I can't see a thing. Anyone got a light?
Oh, you know, I'm glad you asked. I always keep this thing on me. I would never come up on stage without it.
Ah, it's not gonna work.
Hey, you dropped something.
His Radio Shack Walkman fell off.
My radio.
And no yelling while I'm gone. Because if you do, how's about I cut your tongue out?
Whenever a pirate... Now I'm sitting here with my mouth is going, okay, great.
Oh, you fool.
How would you feel if he started yelling out of nowhere?
Cobb, seriously, man, quit your yapping. We're trying to get something done here.
With these pins of wings?
So you knew the whole time.
Yeah, I did.
Bob said about God.
And then I'll look at the map. You'll be like, it should be here. Oh, let's go. Oh, sorry.